Hello everyone, I am Dr. A. Sai Padma, Assistant Professor, Bhavan Swekananda College, Sainikpuri, Secunderabad. In this video, I will be looking at ribose switch. What are these ribose switches? The nature of the ribose switch is the RNA, it is the mRNA, where the ribose switches are located either at the 5' untranslated regions are at the 3' untranslated regions are sometimes in the introns within the mRNA sequences. And these sensors are capable of binding a great variety of small molecules such as vitamins, amino acids and nucleotides. And what is their function? They control the transcription or translation of the host mRNA. And these ribose switches are classified basically into the largest class and the second largest class. The biggest class, which includes various coenzymes such as adenosyl cobalamin, thymine pyrophosphate, flavin mononucleotide, S-adenosyl methionine, S-adenosyl homocysteine, tetrahydrofolate and molybdenum and tungstate cofactors. And coming to the second largest group, which binds to the purines are the purine derivative compounds such as adenine, guanine, free quercetin and cyclic DIGMP, cyclic DIMP. And they also recognize amino acids, for example lysine, glycine, glutamine and some of the metal ions as magnesium ions and some of the metabolites like glucosamine, 6-phosphate. And these are the various structures of the ribose switches of thymine pyrophosphate, guanine, flavin mononucleotide, L-glutamine and S-adenosyl methionine. So here the representation is given in the two-dimensional and three-dimensional conformation. Usually these are small in size, which are located either at the 5' untranslated region or 3' untranslated region or sometimes within the introns of the pre-mRNA transcripts. And regulation of the gene expression, what kind of the genes they control? They control the genes which are involved in the biosynthesis or the degradation or the signaling or transport of the metabolites to which these ribose switches belongs. And they create a negative feedback regulatory mechanism to maintain the adequate levels of these small metabolites in the metabolic process. When the levels of the metabolite increases, binding to the ribose switch occurs by these small metabolites like thymine pyrophosphate or S-adenosyl methionine or glucosamine 6-phosphate, which leads to the down regulation of the expression levels of the metabolite related genes. So subsequently the enzymes which are involved in the synthesis of these metabolites and ultimately the metabolite itself. And this negative feedback mechanism happens with a very limited amount of time, because there is an immediate regulation at the level of the mRNA by these metabolites. And coming to the structure of the ribose switch basically consists of two important regions. One is called as an aptamer and other region called as an expression platform. Aptamer is the region where the ligand binds, and the expression region is the where which controls the expression of the gene at the level of the mRNA synthesis or at the level of the protein synthesis. And these ribose switches are mostly occurs in the prokaryote and fungi and plant also, but the number of the instances which are reported in the eukaryotes is comparatively less compared to the prokaryotes. And in the prokaryotes, these ribose switches are usually located within the 5' untranslated regions, and they act by two different ways. If you observe this figure here, this is the example where the ribose switches are involved in the regulation of the transcription, how it is happening. So here, for example, in the bacterial ribose switches, they are located in the 5' untranslated regions. There is no ligand, that is small metabolite, bound here. So the aptamer is in the open conformation, and the expression platform also is not stopping the transcription because it is not in the termination conformation. So the mRNA will be continued RNA polymerase will continue the transcription of the respective gene which is involved in the synthesis of that particular metabolite, whereas upon binding of the ligand to this aptamer changes the conformation, and that conformation will be percolated to the expression platform and which will attain a terminator conformation which will terminate the transcription by dissociation of the RNA polymerase from the DNA. So the mRNA will not be further continued, and mRNA will not be synthesized in full length. So there is no protein, no enzyme which is required for the synthesis of this particular ligand, a small metabolite. And coming to the other way of the regulation of the gene expression is at the level of the synthesis of the protein. Here, if we observe, in the absence of the ligand, the aptamer is in the open conformation. The mRNA here, what we have to consider is mRNA is already transcribed to full length. So, the mRNA is bearing the ribosome binding site, and which is freely available for the ribosome to bind, and it goes to the initiator codon, and then the total mRNA will be translated to the polypeptide, and that in turn is the enzyme which is involved in the synthesis of the small metabolite. But if the ligand is already present in excess, that has to given a negative feedback regulation. That is happening how? By going and binding to the ribosphage at the aptamer region, and this undergoes conformational change, in turn makes the ribosome binding site unavailable for the conformational change of the expression region, expression platform region. So here the ribosome binding site is sequestered, not available for the binding of the ribosome. So even the mRNA is there, that will not be available for the binding of the ribosome, and the protein will not be synthesized, and the synthesis of this metabolite will not happen till further levels of this metabolite comes to normal or down to normal. And in the eukaryotes, has already been mentioned earlier, the number of the riboswitches which are reported are comparatively less to the prokaryotes. There is a TPP binding ribose switch that has been described, where they may control splicing by either halting or promoting the gene expression. Whereas in the prokaryotes and fungi, ribose switches are usually present in the 5 prime untranslated region, whereas in the plants, the ribose switches are usually present in the 3 prime untranslated regions. This is with respect of the thymine pyrophosphate they have studied. And the examples of the fungi are Aspergillus and the Neurospora, where the thymine pyrophosphate ribose switch is located in the 5 prime untranslated region and controls the expression by directing the splicing of the intron which is located in this 5 prime untranslated region. So the last point what we can mention about the importance of the ribose switches is being used as the antibiotic targets. The ribose switches can be used as a target for the novel antibiotics. One example is given here, pyrethymine. Pyrethymine has the structural resemblance to the thymine. After administering as an antibiotic, it goes into the bacterial cell, gets converted into pyrethymine pyrophosphate, where it goes and then binds and then changes the conformation of the thymine pyrophosphate ribose switch, and the thymine pyrophosphate ribose switch will go into the off conformation, and it will stop the synthesis of thymine pyrophosphate, or it will stop the import of the thymine pyrophosphate from the host cell. That is one way where the antibiotics will help in regulating the metabolite concentration in the bacterial cell. The other potential advantage of the ribose switches is the ribose switches genes are present in multiple numbers in the prokaryotic genome. So each operon will be preceded by the ribose switch. Upon binding of the metabolite onto that particular ribose switch will stop that particular operon. By in case to adopt for the antibiotic, by developing the antibiotic resistance, there will be a mutation which may be taken up by the bacterial genome, but since there are many number of the same type of the ribose switches are there, multiple mutations will not be possible even for the bacteria to evade these antibiotics and further develop the antibiotic resistance. So these are the advantages of the ribose switches can be looked into perspective of the antibiotic target. And these contents are being taken under the open educational resources. Thank you very much.